This is the gargoyle of the Front Row Fanatics, and you're watching my two good friends on Top Rope Reality. What you want?
Top Row Ready. I'm Rudolph Hogan.
And I'm Senekala.
And this is part two of episode 149, our big year ender right here at Top Row Reality, as we're standing right here, or sitting in front of
a warm
fire.
We are styling and profiling in front of the nice, warm, toasty fireplace.
Nice little Ric Flair huggies on.
Not huggies, those are diapers for children.
New Pierre should have topped off my drink. What did you put in here? Less egg and more nog.
This man just said we got huggies on.
My scarf. You talk.
We're going to tell you about it. He's got his Jericho scarf. He's got his reindeer thing going. I got the Santa Claus thing, and I'll tell you what else we got. We've got our brand spanking new Ric Flair snuggies. I'm talking.
Woo!
It looks just like a Ric Flair robe, except for it's only on the front side. So if it was Ric Flair, he would love these things because, you know, he loves to walk around naked. We are not, though.
We're not.
But we are sitting here. We are going to tell you all about part two. What? We're not? Oh, you better not be. We're going to tell you all about part two right now as we are in our snuggish.
Not our huggies, our snuggies.
Not our huggies. I cannot believe this man just said we were sitting in our huggies. We are not wearing diapers.
Depends.
One day.
We're going to start with a dark match. Salvatore Sincere. Yes,
we're
March 3rd. Defeated Alex Porte in 7:49.
Very good. Dark match. Doug Furness and Phil LaFon defeated Aldo Montoya and Bob Holly. We saw that last week. Oh, last time we did this.
Yes.
But their last week they did that match. 8:29.
We have Hunter Hearst Helmsley defeated Bret Hitman Hart by disqualification in 17:20. That's
a long match.
It's a good match there.
Given that.
But it's disqualification though.
Then we got Rocky Maivia, the champion of the Intercontinental Championship, defeated Vader with Paul Bearer by disqualification. Mm. I don't know. Two disqualifications in a row now.
Never good.
Not a good thing. But that lasted 15:01, by the way.
We got the Sultan defeating Flash Funk.
Flash, you are so funky!
In 11:17. That's three long matches.
Long matches. That's why I'm saying they're in the two. They are in the 2 hours then.
Mm.
They have to be.
They have to be.
They have to be.
Or less talking.
Sycho Sid, the WWF Champion, defeated Mankind with Paul Bearer to retain his championship in 10:28. So Paul Bearer's people not having good luck.
This is kind of weird. Then we have a dark match where it's Ahmed Johnson defeating Leif Cassidy in 6:18.
But then we have another match that doesn't say dark match, as in it's on the television. That's really weird.
That is very weird.
As it's British Bulldog defeating Owen Hart in the WWF European Championship Tournament Finals to win the vacant European Championship, 16:58. So maybe the dark match is supposed to be at the end of this thing, or it's a misprint and it's not a dark match. But
Because they got tiles. No, the dark matches?
The dark matches up there have tiles. It's very odd.
It is weird.
It's very odd.
Somebody made a mistake.
Or somebody did.
Now we're switching over to Monday Night Nitro.
Nitro! This is my people's Nitro.
And we have a dark match to start off Nitro. It's Ernest Miller, the cat, defeating Yuji Nagata.
Sure, why not? Then we have Konnan, the Barbarian, and Hugh Morrus defeating, oh my gosh, Jeff Jarrett and Steve McMichaels with Deborah McMichaels. Deborah Marshall? Okay, that's a misprint. It's supposed to be Deborah McMichaels at this time. Marshall is one of the names, but she's had quite a few names.
Yes.
Like Williams, because of Steve Austin. 3 minutes, 13 seconds. Wow. They must have been arguing. That's probably what it was. Remember, I told you they've been having problems.
We have DDP defeating Rick Fuller in 2 minutes and 8 seconds.
Not related to Colonel Rob Parker, though. Yeah. Juventud Guerrera defeated Ray Mendoza Jr. Not Booyaka Booyaka. In 5:06.
We have Dean Malenko defeating Mike Enos. Not Knox. Yes. In 4 minutes and 28 seconds.
Go back to last week's episode, he called him Mike Knox.
And I think it was against Dean Malenko.
And I think it was too. Eddie Guerrero defeated the Ultimo Dragon with Sonny Ono in 3 minutes, 49 seconds.
Well, these are two names we heard in a while. Scotty Riggs defeated Michael Wallstreet via disqualification in 4 minutes and 27 seconds.
Probably on WCW Saturday Night, or WCW Worldwide. Rey Mysterio Jr., Booyaka Booyaka, defeated Mr. JL, Jerry Lynn, in 4:06.
And the main event, in a no contest, a terrible main event, as the total package, Lex Luger and the Giant, fought Rick and Scott Steiner. Why they just put Rick and Scott Steiner?
They said Rick Steiner and Scott Steiner. Very weird.
No contest, folks.
Which, you know, is interesting. Kevin Nash was doing an interview, and he was calling Rick Steiner Robbie. So I wonder if Rick is not his real name. Maybe because he's calling Robbie Steiner. I was like, that's weird.
That's weird. Now we're jumping over to Nitro and Raw, and we're going to do March the 10th.
March the 10th. As Jeff oh my gosh! And Steve Michaels, who could not defeat Konnan and Hugh Morrus.
Yes.
But they can, if you quit moving it.
I was having to go back up because I couldn't, it was kind of like Konnan and...
I couldn't remember his name at first, but I wasn't looking. I was looking here. Defeated High Voltage, Kenny Chaos, and Robbie Rage in 4:45.
Then we got Prince Iaukea, the television champion, defeating Dave Taylor in 2 minutes and 48 seconds.
Then we got D. No, we do not D. No. Sorry, I jumped a line. We have Eddie Guerrero, who is your United States champion, defeating Jim Powers with Teddy Long, 2 minutes 52 seconds.
Then we have D. Now we have D. P. defeating Sergeant Craig Pittman with Teddy Long at 4:20.
Oh, who's having a good time?
RVD.
Oh, there it goes. Rey Mysterio Jr.
Booyaka, booyaka, booyaka.
Something. That eggnog has got you, boy.
Booyaka, booyaka, 619.
Defeated the cell phone. Yes, if you watched last week's episode, you would know what I'm talking about because he defeated Galaxy in 3:21.
Then we have Lex Luger, the Giant, Ricks, and Scott Steiner.
That's weird.
As they defeated Greg Valentine, Roblox, Jacques Rougeau, and Pierre in 2 minutes and 11 seconds.
You were on the show! What'd you get on Nitro, Pierre? I thought it was Carl. I thought his name was Carl. They changed his name.
They changed or he got fired. They put some else in there.
They put Pierre in there. You were so young. You weren't even born yet. I don't think, wait.
Nope.
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 It was 98, wasn't it?
Yep.
Oh, young whippersnapper. Next, we have the Ultimo Dragon defeating Juventud Guerrero. The juice. 4 minutes and 53 seconds. Speaking of the juice, what you got over there?
We got Scotty Riggs again defeating Chris Jericho.
What? Oh, that's
a disqualification in 3:38. I know.
Skidman. I mean, I was okay with Scotty Riggs, but not that okay with him.
Okay.
Don't know why. The horrible main event.
How could this be a main event?
Better have been a daggone promo at the end. There must have been a promo at the end of this show. As the actual main event. Because Kevin Sullivan took on Hard Body Harrison, who's in jail for life. By the way, prison, not jail. Prison for life. ended in a double count out in 2 minutes. A double count out. Man was a jobber.
What are they trying to do?
I guess Kevin Sullivan was just beating the tar out of him and just went out of the ring still beating the tar out of him.
I guess so.
Horrible event.
Okay, here we're starting like I told you. Now we're starting with Raw here, folks. It's the Intercontinental Champion, Rocky Maivia, defeating Tony Roy.
I like that old Tony Roy guy.
Tony Roy.
He was always a real good.
He was a Roy fan.
I'll tell you, Roy was good. Wow, you really did that to me on purpose there, didn't you? Peruth.
No, that's why it fell.
No. You made it fall that way.
Yeah.
Peruth, Heavy Metal, and Pentagon defeated Latin Lover, Hector Garza, God rest your soul, and Octagon.
Yeah, see?
I did okay. I did okay. The first one was a little iffy.
Then I got this one again. Ahmed Johnson defeated Roy Raymond.
Those Roys, they doing real good with themselves. People. Tony Roy, Roy Raymond. That would have been a good tag team, the Roys.
The Roy Boys.
The Roy Boys, Tony and Raymond. The Roy Boys. No times on these, by the way.
No times.
Very awful.
Two times.
Oh, my gosh.
For a while, we don't have no times.
Blackjack Windham and Blackjack Bradshaw defeated the WWF Tag Team Champions Owen Hart and the British Bulldog via disqualification. About to say, because if they beat them regular, that's sad.
Miguel Perez defeated Leif Cassidy. Who hasn't?
Right. Even himself. Billy Gunn defeated Aldo Montoya with the jock strap on his head.
Goldust when Marlena defeated Tim Magneti.
Magneti!
Yeah, they're up to 2 hours.
Magneti! They're trying to fill in.
And they've run out of wrestlers.
They have.
We got two Roys and a Magneti so far.
That guy we had last week, bring him back. He'll be Magneti this week. Yes. Lord, Vader and Mankind with Paul Bearer defeated. Defeated. The Undertaker and the WWF World Heavyweight Champion, Sycho Sid, when Vader defeated The Undertaker after Sid powerbombed his partner as the two began fighting each other. I wonder why.
Because they're leading to WrestleMania.
What?
Then we go to two dark matches.
Why?
As in one dark match, The Undertaker defeated Farouk by disqualification.
He went literally from getting powerbombed to winning a match.
And the second one is?
Sycho Sid, who was just powerbombing his partner, defeated Bret Hart in a steel cage match to retain the championship. Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Well, they're definitely in 2 hours, though. They're struggling, but they're in 2 hours.
Now we're back to Monday Night Raw here on March the 19th. As we go with the Legion of Doom.
Did you say the 19th?
17th.
Wow. I'll tell you, the juice has got you.
As with the Legion of Doom, defeated Savio Vacant Crush. With the Nation, it's not the Nod anymore.
It's not the Nod anymore.
Via disqualification.
Somebody else must have wrote that down.
With disqualification,
though. I hate it. Hunter Hearst Helmsley with China defeated Flash Funk because he is so funky with the pedigree. Funkettes, I guess?
No, I guess not. Mini Goldust and Marceretta Sagrada Jr.
Sure, why not?
Yeah. Defeated Mini Vader and Mini Mankind.
I'm sorry.
We're 2 hours, folks.
I'm sorry. The Sultan with the Iron Sheik and Mr. Bob Backlund defeated Mike Bell via submission.
Ring my bell. Ring my bell.
Ring my bell.
Davey Warner Smith.
Go get dizzy.
The European champion, with Owen, defeated Vader with Paul Bearer and Mankind via qualification to retain the
title. Midgets couldn't even win their matches either. Paul Bearer's got a horrible crap. Okay, so Billy Gunn.
Bang, bang.
He last week he had Aldo Montoya. This time he's got Aaron Ferguson. He beat him via submission with an R bar. When did Billy Gunn use submission?
I know.
Weird.
Sycho Sid, the WWF champion, defeated Bret Hart in a steel cage match to retain the WWF title.
So basically they said that was a really good dark match. Let's put that on television. Because then the actual dark match was Ahmed Johnson, Goldust, which is surprising they're teaming because remember, Goldust kissed Ahmed Johnson.
Yes.
And The Undertaker defeated the Nation of Domination, Crush, Farouk, and Savio Vega. So basically, they beat the Nod.
They beat the hell out of the Nod.
Yes.
And now we're going to jump over to Nitro as Rey Mysterio Jr.
Sure.
Booyaka, booyaka, 619. Defeated Psychosis. Yeah, Psychosis.
Hey, that's a good match.
Yes.
She probably had a good time, too.
Get the people to learn how to time it.
Right. DDP defeated Max.
Maximum.
Two X's.
Konnan and Hugh Morrus defeated the Renegade.
He's not the Ultimate Warrior.
And Joe Gomez.
It's an every time thing. Better get used to it, people. And then we've got Dean Malenko, who I thought he was the Cruiserweight Champion. I think they messed that up.
Unless he won the pay-per-view.
I do think so. We're going to call it like it says it, but I don't think so. Because who was the champion the week before?
What, the United States champion?
Yes, the champion? The United States. Both, really. Yeah. United States was Eddie Guerrero. Go up one more. Cruiserweight. Whoa, slow down right there. Where's the Cruiserweight at? Where'd he go? No Cruiserweight matches?
Nope, they're Team Malenko.
Not doing nothing. No. That's weird, because I thought he was the Cruiserweight champion. Keep going.
Last week he was, because it's Cruiserweight versus United States, remember?
It was.
And you said, hi, Icky, how can a Cruiserweight be the United States champion?
That's right.
That's right.
So, but we're going to call it like it says. Okay, Dean Malenko claims he's the U.S. champion, defeated Scotty Riggs to retain the belt.
We have Lex Luger and the Giant defeating Knuckles, Nelson, and Tarantula.
Wow, they're really pulling names out of a hat at this point. Oh my gosh, the Ultimo Dragon defeated Bobby Eaton, and I wish I knew the time because I'd get upset.
Jeff Jarrett and Steve Mongo McMichaels defeated Alex Wright.
That's one to kid.
And Mark Starr.
With two R's because he's such a star.
Yes.
Scott Norton defeated Chavo Guerrero Jr.
The Outsiders, Kevin Nash and Scott Hall, the WCW World Tag Team Champions, defeated Bunkhouse Buck and Mike Enos.
Not rough and ready. Not rough and ready. We thought we saw a picture of them one time, but it was them two. It wasn't rough and ready.
That's right.
Rough and ready, ladies and gentlemen, if you didn't know, is Mike Enos and Dick Slater.
You should know.
You should know this by now if you watch our show every time. It's rough and ready. Sounds like a horrible, horrible porn video or a condom. One of the two.
Yes, one of the two.
But that's the name of their tag team. We're just being honest here. It's the name of their tag team. Where are we at now?
You're at the second from the one underneath that. The next one after the Outsiders.
Oh. Chris Benoit?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Defeated Billy Kidman.
And the main event, Rick and Scott Steiner fought the Harlem Heat to a no contest.
Why is your main event a no contest? They do that almost every week.
Hope it was somebody speaking, which would be NWO. So.
Of course it would be the NWO. But then we're going to continue with Nitro March the 24th as Dean Malenko, apparently he's at the belt. They keep saying it. I'm going to have to go back and watch it now. Dean Malenko, they say and still, he's a U.S. champion. I never thought he won the U.S. belt. I thought he was always Cruiserweight. Defeated Konnan via submission to retain the belt. Now I'm just curious.
Now it's driving you crazy.
It is driving me insane.
We got Mortis defeating Jerry Flynn.
Remember Mortis?
Remember Mortis.
Then we got La Parca defeating Juventud Guerrera. The Juice.
Then we got High Voltage.
Yeah.
Defeating Public Enemy. Wow, really?
That's sad.
Yes,
Public Enemy was on the way out.
They were.
That is.
There's the door.
There's the door.
The door.
Okay. Oh, is it me next?
It is you.
You made sure I got this one, didn't you? Psychosis defeated Super California the Expialidocious.
You love it. Hugh defeated Chris Benoit.
Nothing to laugh about there.
There's nothing to laugh about that.
Well, that would be more exciting like we're laughing, but nothing there.
No, we're not.
Not laughing at all. Harlem Heat defeated the Faces of Fear, Ming and the Barbarian. They got it right that time.
It did.
Ming and the Barbarian.
Next one, Rick and Scott Steiner defeated Jacques Rougeau and Carl Olivet.
Why did it say Pierre last week? Not last week we filmed, but last week on their show, it said, or 2 weeks ago, it said Pierre.
No telling.
Not very happy about that.
As you will.
Medusa defeated Mila Hosaka.
Hosaka. Yeah, it's a Hosaka. We got Jim Duggan. Ho! Defeating the Renegade.
Not the Ultimate Warrior. We were right on time there, wasn't we? What is the world is this?
Where's he been?
Lord, he's been protecting people, protecting Miss Elizabeth from other people, is what it was.
I guess.
Prince Iaukea, your WCW World Television Champion, in a championship match, in the only main event he's ever seen in his life, because of who his opponent was, beat Randy Savage, basically, because it ended in a no contest. Again, 2 weeks in a row, main event, no contest.
That's bad writing.
So I'm hoping the NWO came out there and beat the crap out of Macho Man. Or
had to beat both of them.
Had to beat both of them up for Prince Iaukea and yeah, because it would have been either that or been the disqualification then. Mm-hmm. Yeah, had to beat them both.
That's what you're hoping for.
That's what I'm hoping for, because by gosh, Prince Iaukea shouldn't be in the main event with Randy Savage. Okay.
And then we jump over to Raw. As we have the Headbangers defeat the WWF Tag Team Champions
and the European
and the European Champion Dave Boy Smith and Owen Hart via disqualification.
That's it.
It's not a good way to start.
They need to learn these things. Hunter Hearst Helmsley with China defeated Bart Gunn with the pedigree.
We had Venom, Supernova, and Discovery defeat Hysteria, Abismo, Negro, and Manico in an AAA match.
Triple A. That's the name of the promotion.
In an AAA match, yes.
It's a triple A.
Just said Triple A on it.
You're awful, sir.
When Nova defeated Negro.
Hey now, wow.
Triple A match. That's when Vince was going, "What is wrong? We're gonna hook it with."
We're gonna try
A.
some things, yeah.
Yeah, that lasted about 6 months.
Before it was a couple of weeks ago, they were hooked up with ECW. Now they're hooking up with a Mexican promotion.
AA.
Triple A.
Alcoholics Anonymous.
Alcoholics Anonymous Anonymous.
Yes, because you really want to be anonymous.
Because he ain't right there. I don't know about. Can you believe a television channel was actually in the match? We got a cell phone losing every match they got. Yes. And a television station won their match. Because Discovery was in the match. That good old Discovery channel. Y'all didn't catch that coming, did you? Tell you what.
What? I just told you.
Exactly. Then we got Flash Funk. Flash, you are so funky. Every time.
Yes.
Defeated. Why?
Don't worry. Why? He'll go away. He'll never get fired someday shortly.
Defeated the Brooklyn Brawler.
Oh. That's before he hooked up with Bobby.
Why?
What? Who? The Brooklyn Brawler. Because when he hooked up with Bobby Heenan, he won his matches. So.
Did you just say this is before that?
Yes.
This was much after that.
Really?
Bobby Heenan went with the company in 97? You are drinking some bad stuff.
Really?
What are you talking about?
Oh, okay.
Brooklyn Brawler was with Bobby Heenan back when Red Rooster was on the roster.
Yeah.
What are you...
That's true.
This is 1997, buddy.
This is 1997.
He's on commentary for WCW.
Well, he needs to lose then. No one he lost.
Where are you coming from?
I just figured he'd be winning.
He's coming from the late 80s. Yes. Early 90s.
That's true.
Flash Funk wasn't a jobber yet. Why would he lose to Brooklyn Brawler?
Well, not when he had Heenan, he wouldn't lose to him.
What are you talking about? Still talking about Heenan.
So if he has Heenan with him, Brawler would have won. You're right.
This man is obsessed with Heenan.
That's true.
But you know he's not going to be with Heenan.
Not now.
But you made it sound like you... He's like, how did he lose? He's with Heenan. How could he have lost? He's with Heenan.
Well, I didn't say he was with
Heenan. Yo, you did.
I said if he was with Heenan.
At first you said he was with Heenan.
No.
So we got the
Instant replay. Maivia
instant replay.
Defeated Leaf Cassidy.
Who hasn't?
I know. Why is he getting them?
It's a non-title match.
He shouldn't even be in there with the champion.
And your main event that I composed myself.
Yes. Which is another...
It's another dud of a main event as Ahmed Johnson defeated Savio Vega with the Nation. The nod is left via disqualification.
And see, those aren't enough matches for 2 hours there.
But we don't know how many times was, though. We don't know the times. Yeah, that's not a lot, but they could have been long matches.
Or a lot of... ring talking.
Mm-hmm.
Now we go to our final week of Raw and
Nitro. Lots of weeks in March.
31st.
Very fast. We start with Raw with the WWF European Champion and Tag Team Champion. David Boy Smith fought the WWF Tag Team Champion, Owen Hart, to a no contest. So wait a second. You got partners facing each other and you let it end in a no contest. This better lead to a pay-per-view match, boys.
Probably does. El Mosco defeated Supernova.
Okay. Wow.
That's more of that AA stuff.
Triple A, yes. Jesse James with two M's. Why does he have two M's? J-E-S-S-E-J-A-M-E-S. That's why they did it. That's why they did it.
Exactly when they did it.
Because that's when he was with, he was the roadie. Or he meant, well, this was, no, because Jeff is in, Jeff is in, what you call it?
He's right in now? WCW right now.
So this is either before or after. I think it was after. Yeah, this was definitely after. Because
like
he was the roller. Yes. Yes.
Heenan, so yeah. This was also after Jeff, yes.
That's after Jeff and Jesse split up. Because Jesse was the one that actually sang his little song.
With My Baby Tonight.
With My Baby Tonight. As he defeated Jerry Fox. Not Jerry Flynn or Jerry Lynn.
Nope.
Jerry Fox. Fox.
Then we got Savio Vega and Crush defeating Adam O'Brien and Rod Bell.
I tell you what a tag team.
Yes.
O'Brien Bell. That's the tag team name. Or is it Bell O'Brien? Oh, I like that.
Yeah.
Bell O'Brien.
He'll be a better wrestler.
Put the names together, people. Make one guy. Goldust defeated Hunter Hearst Helmsley via disqualification. Two in a row.
Yes.
And a no contest. They didn't have one. They didn't have but one, two, three clean wins, and it was all jobber matches.
Yes, because the main event was Intercontinental Champion Rocky Maivia defeated Bret Hart by disqualification.
So you had two disqualifications in a row, and you had a no contest to open the show. What is wrong with you, Vince? What's wrong with you?
Just one lost 83 weeks in a row
consecutively. Then we're going to go to WCW Nitro March 31st. And you open up with a tag team match as Lex Luger The Giant defeated Rick Fuller and Roadblock.
And then we went to a singles match as Psychosis defeated Villanova's Four.
WCW World Television Championship title match as Prince Iaukea defeated La Parka to retain the title.
Then we came back with another singles match as Chris Jericho defeated Lord Steven Regal.
Exactly. WCW World Women's title match. Where'd that go from?
I don't know.
Goodness. As Aroka Hokato. The champion defeated Debbie Cobbs. Don't ask me who either one of those people are. Combs? What did I say? Cobbs? That's not Cobbs. That's Combs.
It's
Combs. That's an M,
she
not...
She worked for WWE, too.
Did she?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know either one of them, but I'm just telling you, their women's division was not very good back then. The only reason they did that belt was because of Medusa.
Mm-hmm.
And it failed miserably. Go ahead.
The amazing French Canadians in a tag team match defeated Jeff Jarrett and Steve Mongo McMichael.
Lord, they're on every show. Why did I get this match? Tushy. Yumatsu.
Tushy.
Look at you with your Tushy out. Okay. Tushy Yumatsu defeated Makio Satomaroa.
That's pretty good.
That must be another women's match. That has to be two women.
Tushy.
That has to be Tushy and Mikoa. That has to be two women.
Yep. I bet it's just two women.
They probably just travel with Akira. Hakota, Kati, Tota.
And then we got Chris Benoit defeating Hugh Morrus.
And then we got DDP defeating Lance Ringo Starr. No, it's just Lance Ringo. But anytime you say Ringo, you kind of have to say Starr.
That's right.
It's Ringo Starr. Yeah.
And then the main event.
Oh, gosh. What the heck?
The Steiner brothers, Rick Steiner and Scott Steiner, because we didn't know there was Steiner brothers.
We did not know that.
Defeated High Voltage. Kenny Chaos and Bobby Reed.
Why are they in the main event? It's like Prince IK being in the main event. What is wrong with you, Eric Bischoff?
Where's the NWO? Where's Nash, Hall, Hogan?
They don't have any match. You notice that?
Savage.
The NWO doesn't wrestle any matches on any of this stuff. There was a lot of promo work on this. A lot of promo. Because they had to get the NWO over somehow at this point. Promos.
That's true, because only when they had to defend the tag team titles, but then you get
business. It's the only time you see Nash and Hall tag title defenses. And that's going to be it for part number two on this holiday big end of special.
We're back for part three as we are who gained, who lost, who stayed the same again. We're going to do some more topics.
Got to have our topics.
So we're going to talk about Clash of the Champions coming up.
It is coming up right around the corner.
No, it's tonight.
It is.
It is tonight.
Tonight. Or today, wherever you're watching
this. Walking.
Wherever you're walking.
Walking, working, looking. Yes.
Woo, that drink got you.
And we're going to...
I can't even remember what day I'm in, so it's got... The drink's got me, too.
And this is the aroma.
The aroma from the eggnog, yes.
And we're going to bring back the pay-per-view redo.
We're redoing it. We're changing it all up.
We're going to do Starrcade 1988.
Probably wasn't even born yet then.
And that's it for part three. It's before
October. Starrcade's before October. Or is it the end of the year? December. Oh, I was 2 months old, yeah.
Holla, 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 holla,
yes. 2 months old, holla,
holla. So come on back to part three. I am Rudolph Hogan.
And I am Santa Cara. I almost forgot my name. Santa Cara.
On this ho, ho, ho of Top Road Reality Big Year Ender. What's it? Well, hey.
Hey.
Wow. It's amazing. Few clicks. No point this time. You can't do it.